people are looking, the hyperscalers are looking to people like us that develop the land with power. It's called powered land to get it going while we're in the process of getting the grid connection. So that's what this press release was so important about, is that we've done such hard work to get it where we've gotten today. And obviously we've got the natural gas here. That's what makes the Permian Basin and such an ideal spot for the data center.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Will Gray. He is the CEO of New Era Helium. And Will, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing well, Steve. Yourself?
I'm doing very well. Thanks very much. And I know you've just announced sort of a landmark joint venture. And we'll talk about this in just a second. But maybe remind everyone this venture, what it's about, and talk about the work that you're doing near your project.
Yeah, so obviously we're New Era Helium, but we're a lot more than that. We're kind of looking at, as when I say new era, really the next generation of, you know, kind of these various power verticals. And one thing that we've really been spending a lot of time and effort on is the co-development of our 250 megawatt data center within the Permian Basin. So, you know, I guess one thing that we're really focused on, just like most other developers like ourselves, are power. That's the key, right? So for any data center, where are you getting your power? Because most of the grid, whether it's in ERCOT, any other jurisdiction, MidCon or on East Coast, I mean, they're just taxed. So for us, we're looking at creating a scenario of behind the meter using what they call recip engines to create our 250 megawatt power facility.
Yeah, so that's what today's news is about, a memorandum of understanding with PowerForward Energy Solutions. So tell me a little bit about them and how this is all going to work.
Yeah, so PowerForward has been great to work with. We have met with, you know, on Texas Critical Data Centers, that's our joint venture with Sharon AI. We have spoken with a number of different power providers looking at different sort of power generations, whether it's combined cycle, turbine, single cycle, looking at recip engines. And obviously there's a backlog on the order. Everyone wants power equipment, power generation equipment. And so working with PowerForward, you know, where their partnerships with ProGen is one of the top recip engine manufacturers within the United States. That was also one of our other factors looking from the tariff perspective and keeping the manufacturing of the power gen equipment, you know, domestic. And so that's been honestly a very big deal, not to mention from a timing standpoint. So obviously one, tariffs, two, timing, three, reliability, and, you know, sustainability, and of course, you know, operational effectiveness.
Now, as far as getting sort of to the next stages of this, I know that the site assessment was successful. Now you're working on air quality. There's a few steps you're going through to get all these permits in place while this, you know, all this behind the scenes work is happening.
Oh, this has just been, it's just not as easy as saying, hey, here's a plot of land. Let's go put a power plant. And then maybe we can get a hyperscaler to build a data center. It doesn't work that way.
It's never that easy.
Maybe I thought I did, but I'm learning real quickly in the past 7 months, it doesn't work that way. I mean, we've had phone calls with the county judge. We've had phone calls with the Chamber of Commerce, understanding what tax abatements look like, you know, the creation of industrial districts to understanding how that looks like to get municipality services from water, waste sewage, you know, all the above, right? And so I think when you look at all of this, it's not just a function of understanding doing a phase one study to say, hey, listen, yes, my acreage is environmentally sound, but also I think what's really interesting and what really differentiates, you know, our project specifically is where it resides, the Permian Basin. One of the largest oil fields in the world. We have a glut of natural gas. Natural gas equals power, power equals AI. That's what we're doing. And so our site specifically is adjacent to three what they call intrastate pipelines that we can tap, and then 7 miles away from an interstate pipeline. So what you want to do is create redundancy, because again, when we're talking about building for hyperscalers, this is not Bitcoin mining. You can't go down. So what they're looking for is 100% reliability. And so for us, redundancy on having taps to multiple gas lines is key. And that's where, you know, we have a multitude of consultants guiding us on this path. And so, you know, as we've talked about in our press releases, you know, we're in talks with a number of hyperscalers. And so ideally, you know, we really had before we put the cart in front of the horse, we really kind of had to get the power nailed down, number one. Because think about it, if you're the end user, you're one of the major hyperscalers, my first question is, okay, where's your power coming from and how fast can you get it to me? Mm-hmm. And the other question is, are you going to do a grid connection? And what's interesting here is, you know, obviously CoreWeave did a great announcement with Applied Digital. So congratulations to Applied doing that deal with CoreWeave. That was great. I believe it's more of a grid connection. But when you look in Texas specifically, there's 120 gigawatts of application in the queue right now. Last year, ERCOT did 86 gigawatts of power by itself. So it takes 12 months just to do your baseload study and even get your application set, not to mention to even approved by ERCOT. So until then, the hyperscalers are looking to people like us that develop the land with power. It's called powered land to get it going while we're in the process of getting the grid connection. So that's what this press release was so important about, is that we've done such hard work to get it where we've gotten today. And mm-hmm. obviously we've got the natural gas here. That's what makes the Permian Basin such an ideal spot for the data center. And I think you're going to be seeing a lot more press releases come out. You saw where LandBridge from Five Point had just come out, where they just did DataBridge coming out with some of their, so you're going to see a lot of data centers here. I'd say the next 3 to 6 months, the news flow about what the Permian Basin is going to produce is going to be mind blowing.
Well, we look forward to more of that. Will, thanks so much. Congratulations on this landmark deal. Great to see you again.
Yeah, you as well, Steve. Thank you very much.
All right, there's Will Gray, the CEO of New Era Helium.